Who steals a Bible?
People steal everything.
Why would we steal one? In theory.
They're rare.
Yeah, it makes them valuable, but not like a Picasso. It's definitely a niche market. It's tough to fence. People get weird about buying stolen religious artifacts.
I think it's an ironied thing, that pesky eighth commandment.
Thou shalt not steal.
Well, it depends what's important to people. Did you know that an original Star Trek dome lunchbox goes for 600 bucks? I don't try to explain it.
No, I can appreciate that, but why this one?
Well, your missing book is famous. It's known as the Healing Bible.
Really? Attribution.
In 1588, the plague passed through Naples. Father Camillus carried the book into disease-stricken ships in the harbor. Not a single person who touched the Bible died.
Good story.
20 years later, a blind girl regained her sight when she rescued the book from a fire. I could give you many more examples.
No, I'm sure you could. Look, maybe you don't steal it for the money. Maybe you steal it because you're a true believer.
A true believer?
You got something better?
Every person in that church has a felony record. Only people I don't suspect are the ones in prison.
So let's start with the faithful.
It cures blind nuns and lepers. Sounds like every story in Sunday school.
Look at this. In 1918, 30,000 people in New York died from the Spanish flu. No one in this parish even caught a cold.
Maybe whoever took it thinks it's gonna heal them.
It's worth looking into.
Nobody in this church caught the flu.
It's true.
Why these guys and not the church down the block? Because of a book? Tough to swallow.
I thought you were Catholic.
Lapsed.
Oh. So you don't think some higher power could have saved the congregation?
Oh, I'm more inclined to think they kept the door shut and loaded up on vitamin C.
Maybe God works with what he's got.
And God said, shut thine doors and eat thine oranges?
Why not?
All right, look. When they dug up King Tut, everybody made such a big deal out of the curse of the pharaoh.
Yeah, 2 dozen people who entered the tomb ended up dead.
Yeah, they probably caught some old bacterial infection. Germs. There's your divine intervention.
God can't use bacteria?
I prefer my miracles with a little more smiting and lightning.
Can I help you?
Thanks for seeing us again, Father. We wanted to run down one thing. You didn't tell us your Bible was also known as a healing Bible.
I didn't think it was relevant.
Could be. Was there anybody in your church who was a true believer of the healing power of the Bible?
Someone who was terminally ill, someone who had a sick family member.
I was afraid this might happen.
What?
Mr. Borelli has discouraged the homeless from the church.
He made you shut down the soup kitchen. How Christian of him.
The night of the theft, I let a homeless man sleep in the sanctuary. His name's Steve.
Is he sick?
No. Someone very close to him is.
Steve?
Hi.
My name is Peter. This is my friend Neal. Do you mind if we ask you some questions? The church you stayed in last week, they're missing a Bible. You know anything about it?
Yeah, I took it.
Great. We need it back.
No, I need it back.
What do you mean? Where is it?
I took it from the church like he asked me to. Now, he said that he would show me how to help Lucy get better. Then he took it from me. Now, he has not brought it back. Do you know where he is?
No, I wish I did.
Who asked you to take the Bible from the church?
Look, he said that he would help Lucy get better. She's not getting better, okay? She's getting worse.
What's wrong with her?
She's tired all the time. She don't eat nothing. Now, if I could get that Bible back, she'll get better.
The man who asked you to take the Bible, did you meet him at the church?
Yeah.
Steve, if we showed you some pictures, do you think you could recognize him?
We just need to get the Bible back, okay? Because she's fading, all right?